flying all across the country, singing every place we go.
There's a new kind of music,
and we're letting everybody know. There's something about this music that makes you wanna sing along. So come on, everybody.
Hi, I'm Charlie Pro, with another exciting visit from one of the outstanding performers who are bringing a new song of praise to gospel music. See if you recognize these hits from the 60s. They were recorded by a group called the Ronettes, girl cousins, who toured with the Beatles and the Rolling Stones. One member of the Ronettes has come full circle in her life. Her name is Nedra Ross. And here's the title cut from her new album, Full Circle.
My hand and let In 1963, late 63, we came out with Be My Baby. By 64, we came out with Baby I Love You, which really hit really big, which was a million seller. And by that time, we were touring Europe a lot. I guess we hit pretty big over in Europe, in the States here. Then we came out with a song called Walking in the Rain, and that was another hit for us. That was in 65, and we retired in 66. At 21, I accepted the Lord, and I just knew where I was at and what the whole music feel was. I had to choose, and it didn't weigh up the music feel next to the Lord to me.
From sunrise to sunset, I know my
fine. There was no major trauma in my life, yet I had never heard anybody really say that Jesus was alive. When I heard that he was alive, and I know it was God at that point just bringing me to a place where I could see him and desire him, it changed my life radically.
You're listening to Nedra Ross, a former member of the famous Ronettes, who is now bringing a new song of love to contemporary Christian music.
It's a whirlwind to be swept off your feet at 17. It had its negative sides. Fortunately, and I know it was the Lord now, he kept us out of a situation where we could have gone in and gotten involved with drugs and a lot of different things.
Never-ending stream.
thing to deal with in some ways was to way of keeping your sanity was you went out on stage, there were the applause, the screams, the whistles, all of that, and so something could be fed in you that could be very, very negative because it was something that a lot of people got caught in where they needed it all the time. So they had to keep pushing for the next record, the next record, the next record. So, you know, that side was really negative. I came from a close-knit family, so I had my feet on the ground, the security of a family. A funny story, like, I would go out and do all these shows, make all this money, and when I came home, I cleaned my room. Took the Stones and the Beatles and said, I see where they really did look. They were looking for something, because we all were. See, because even for the Beatles to reach what they reached, you know, it could really build you up so high that you'd say, there's nobody bigger than me, so I don't, there's no need. Yet there is a need. We saw it when they went to this thing or the next thing, looking, you know. For the Stones, I watched. I mean, they rebelled in a lot of ways. They were friends too. They looked. I used to date Brian, and he's dead. He was looking for something and couldn't find it. And one of the things he found was drugs, and it killed him. Bring in a new song.
This is Charlie Pro. We'll be right back with Nedra Ross, bringing more new songs of faith right after this.
Bring in a new song.
This is Charlie Pro. We're back with Nedra Ross, a former member of the world-famous Ronettes, who after several years away from performing music, is now bringing a new song of praise to contemporary Christian music. Here's Nedra singing a Ted Sandquist song, Without Him.
Without him, I'm a cloud without rain. I'm raging forest fire without flame. I'm a cold and hungry orphan with no name. I'm a rock and roll star without fame. Without him is hard to explain. You could say I'm a cloud without rain. Without room, tree. I'm a treetop nightingale that can't sing. I'm a monarch butterfly without wings. I'm a bride left on the church step with no ring. Without him I've no song to sing. In my life I'm no gift for the king. He's a well of living water that I drink from every day. He is the bridegroom that I look for, and he's coming.
Without Him is a very special song. Ted Sankwich wrote that. It's the type of song that when it was brought to our fellowship and we were just singing it and singing it and singing it, the Lord stopped us and said, it has to be a reality, you know. So the without Him, you know, I'm a cloud without rain. I'm a raging forest fire without flame, that type of thing. Who I am without the Lord. So that's a special song.
You write the words and the songs to the beat of my heart. I'm singing the song to you. You write the words and the song to the beat of my heart. I'm singing the song to you. You write the lyric and the melody. Instill the meaning into poetry. Inspire the
husband Scott Ross has been a great influence on her.
I knew him from when I was 16, and then I started dating him when I turned 19, and 2 years of dating, all the glamour was around me at that point, you know. Yet I was in love with him, so that was some kind of a balancing factor for me too, so that I wasn't out there just, and all the guys and the whole thing. I did have my boyfriend at home. Just before I was 21, we went down to Maryland for a draft. He had to report to the draft board about something. And to appease his mother, we went to services with her. And from that point, it changed my life. Not just that we walked into a church. I had been into churches. He had been raised in the church. But it was God really speaking to two people that were there at that point and saying, you need your lives changed. Keith Green's song is really special. When Scott heard that, he said, that's just definitely Nedra. I don't want to fall away from you. And that's really been my cry, too. It's been 11 years, and I don't believe I'll ever fall away from the Lord with His grace. To Germany right after I accepted the Lord because of contracts. We went to Germany and there was this nice looking guy, you know, that was in one of the groups, you know, and I was talking to him. I told him I just accepted the Lord, and he said, oh, really? And so I began to just, you know, lay it all out who the Lord was, and he said, you give me 2 weeks and you'll change your mind. And I went, 2 weeks. I said, I won't change my mind.
Gonna let
For what's come about in the last 10 years, sometimes Scott and I just were overwhelmed with what the Lord's done in 10 years. So in 10 years, I don't even have an idea of what's going to happen. I know it's going to be double what has happened in the last 10 years. You know, I'm totally excited, but I can't say that, I'm reaching for any set goals. I have no goals set except my calling in the Lord.
We've been listening to Nedra Ross and songs from her new album, Full Circle, bringing a new song to contemporary Christian music. We'd like to thank Word Incorporated, New Song Records, Paul Baker, and Mark Sorrells for the material used in this show. Produced by Charles Wallace Incorporated. My name is Charlie Pro. See you next time.